Hamish, Andy. Oh, Hamish and Andy, the comedians. Oh, I'm following them on Twitter. I kid you not. I clicked on... What did I do again? I clicked on the comedian section in Twitter, and all the Australian comedians come up. So it's like my duty as a good citizen of the world to click on at least 10 of them. And yeah, that means that it's popular, hey. If I upload my stuff now and they go, oh, comedy, I'm a comedian, I'll listen to comedy. It's like, comedians, if they think I'm funny, then I actually am funny, hey. Hey, doing a comedy test, hey. I've got this, oh, it's got 2 views now. Hey, 2 views. I've got this, video on YouTube called Funny Dunny, and it's been on there since like nearly a whole week or two, hey. And yes, as of last night, it had 0 views to it. I was very impressed because when I did it, I thought it was like major mainstream, like excellence, hey. And it just hasn't caught on in a whole 2 weeks. No one even watched it. So I'm going to test this funny one, Funny Dunny Funny, out on the comedians on Twitter and see if I get more than 2 views in a day, people will think it's funny, eh? Funny, funny, oi, oi, that's what I'm going to write with it. This is very good, eh? This is my comedian's test. If the funnies come up, or because my stats have gone up for more than 2 views, the comedians have bloody watched it on YouTube, hey? Funny, funny, oi, oi, I'm writing that up there now. You wait there, you can listen to the keys type themselves, hey? Ready? Funny, funny, oi, oi, oh, God. Yeah, yeah, this will get me. I hope, I hope this is good, eh? Let's follow these things too. Usually I just seem to go, you know, only follow who's following me, because I'm not really a Twitter head, you know, Twitter head freak, you know, I'm not socially addicted yet to Twitter. But anyway, I might become that way, but anyway, because I'm not like that yet, I've actually taken the first step to get my own followers who didn't actually follow me first. Like, you know, I've got something like, here, let me bring up the stats on it, hey. Hey, I got messages, ooh. Here we go, Paul O'Reilly coming right up. Dun, 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 dun. Hey, this is taking a while. We need more drum roll. Dun, 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 dun. Hey, here we go. I've got 209 followers. Hey, so that's like people followed me, but I'm following 367. So that's like nearly 160. People that were following me and then didn't anymore. So I'm kind of backloading the Twitter vibe. Oh, shock horror, it's true. So I have to follow all the comedians now. This is my new rule. Thank you. Stop following the comedians, hey. Pick a comedian page on Twitter. Do this for an experiment, fans and fans alike out there. And don't say, you know, if their little tweet thing introduction makes you laugh, you have to follow them. That's one of the rules. Also, if you like the look of them because you think they're really cool, you have to follow them because it's, you know, a chemistry thing. You'll think they're funny if you like them. and, you know, how do you stop following comedians, eh? It's like, oh, down to, like, you know, number 90 or something. Oh, how many have I ticked, eh? following, ah, too many, howdy, ah. Whatever, eh? It's going to be a funny day. I can feel it in my bones. I can feel it in my bones. Thank you. It's a claim to fame. Hey, Hamish and Andy, you know the Aussie comedians that are so super cool, super beyond excellence, you know. Well, I've pulled up Andy Lee's Twitter page, right? And wait for it. Let me click this button. I was going to say, oh yeah, I can tweet to Andy Lee. I can send Andy a tweet. Hey, that's a claim to fame. Hey, imagine if I sent Andy a tweet. That'd be like, dun, 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 dun. Fairy Princess tweeted to the famous comedian. That's like fame itself, nearly. Hey, this could be another Hollywood Hits resume coming itself. Hey, God bless everything again. Must admit, it's not quite fine, but it's nearly good enough, eh? I'm on my way, I can feel it in my bones. Thank you. Nearly famous, I retweeted one of Andy's tweets, eh? Oh man, pack of old bobby cars all lined up that are all burnt out and bobby. And it's something about the good parking zone or something. Whatever, it's funny. I retweeted it. Ah, claim to fame me. Okay, retweeting is nearly fame itself. God bless everything. I love Twitter now. I get it. Leewood. Hollywood. Open the gates. I'm coming through. Hollywood. 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 Woo. I want to do it again. Get enough of that noise, eh? Look out, world. I'm gonna hit the big time with this one. Oh, God, that's what the Moose crowd say on some of my other comedy albums. Woo-hoo! I don't care if you got no connective lingual sync in your brains about my comedy albums. It's still funny, eh? When they ask you on Trivia Nights, what did the Moose crowd say? You'll all be able to go, woo-woo, woo-woo. God bless Paul O'Reilly Comedy Hub. Thank you. I realise if I want to get into Hollywood with this new Hollywood Hits album resume number 6, I'm going to have to, like, pick my language wisely, you know. I'm tossing up whether to reply on Andy Lee's tweet. He goes, they say mathematics is an international language. I say over-enunciating English words with wild hand movements is. You know, that's fair enough. It's pretty funny, eh? Blah, 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 blah. You could get the picture of that, hey? Blah, 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 with the big hand movements. But I think it's funny. So should I reply to this tweet and say something? Like, what would I say, eh? You know, I want to look good in the eyes of Andy Lee. It's like he can think I'm famous too, eh? Or near similar, whatever. But, you know, what can I say? I have to learn the Twitter etiquette lingo ethics code of the day. What should I say? And he's already famous. Should I go the big hog on it and just rip out the funniest thing I can think of? Or should I, like, you know, kind of suck up a bit? And think that's a bit funny, eh? I don't know. I want to rip out the big hog on it, eh? I want to do the all-time funniest. Thank you. But there's bound to be a, like, ethics board on Twitter communication. I don't know. I'm new to it. I have to get there. I have to learn it. Oh, Twitter, God blessings be. Woo-woo. Thank you.
Oh, Python, sting bang, sting bang, sting bang. It's out.
Hey, if anyone's ever bored, just like go down Andy Lee tweets. They're all funny. I love it. I'm having dilemmas for my Hollywood hits resume number 6 on which one I'm gonna actually reply to. Hey, this is a big thing for me. It's not like a little step forward for the history of mankind. It's like you got to study every Andy Lee movement on Twitter and then pick which one you're gonna retweet. It's like, oh, bloody LA, Hollywood hits, here I come. Oh, man, which one? With this one, he's got like a giant bear. That's funny. This one, the poo won't flush down the gap when you're a guest at someone's house. That's fucking ridiculously embarrassingly funny. Oh god, there's a funny car. Okay, I'll get back to you. I haven't read enough yet. But if you're ever bored, just go to Andy Lee's Twitter page. Hey, I love it. It's funny, man. Funny as. If you're ever upsetting your neighbours with your like comedic voice on your voice recorder, right? Should you like, you know, trying to be a comedian and everything, you know, get the whole world to think you're funny so you can make $1 billion out of it? Because you're funny and that's why you got $1 billion, because you got big goals and stuff, because you're funny. You know, I've got big goals, hey. I got like comedic standing in my own right, in my own mind, in my own brain, in my own circumstance of the universe being funny, they're related. But you know, if you're pissing your neighbours off with your voice and stuff like woo-woo-woo-woo and all that carry on stuff, you know, it's not that bad because my voice recorder's so close to my mouth it just sounds like I'm yelling. Woo-woo-woo-woo-woo-woo. But if you are, say you did piss them off, like, it's like a bit of a kickback, eh? Like, you know, if your neighbours can't even handle how funny you are, how's the rest of the world gonna take it, eh? Oh man, just shut up, eh? Woo-woo, shut up, woo-woo. So, yeah, just get back to Andy Lee and forget about that one, eh? Hey, Mr. Dead Andy, to eat a 2.2 kilo giant gummy bear by the end of the year. And I'm just about to watch the video, hey? That's like rip rottenly, snortly, chift off your blockicus funny, hey? I love gummy bears, man. They're so cool. They're funny, hey? I don't know how this is going to get me into Hollywood talking about all the funnies of the other comedians, but gee, I love Andy, hey? Oh, he's so funny. I love comedians, they're so funny. Hollywood. Hollywood. Open the gates because I think they're funny. God bless everything again. Man, imagine, right, if I get famous, you know, whatever. I love gummy bears so much, I'd like ask for 2 of them, hey? No, wait, I'd ask for like 10 of them, hey? You think you're giving me a year for this? Give me 10 of them, I love gummy bears, hey? Gummy bears, gummy bears, gummy bears, woo-woo. Hollywood, open the gates, I'm coming through. Woo-woo. I posted a comment on Andy's gummy bear challenge, hey? I said, you should ask for another one to get you through the year, because, you know, he ate the gummy bear in 45 days. And then I said, I love gummy bears. So I thought that was so funny. I'm learning this Twitter etiquette today. This is not actually Twitter. This is their website. Oh, goody. I love it. I'm going to learn. I'm going to read every single one of Andy's tweets and then pick one and give it my best, hey, give it my all, give it a big old thing. Oh, God bless everything. I'm going to get to Hollywood. I want to be funny like the goodies. Hamish and Andy, oh, God bless everything and all the other goodies out there. Oh, bad. Okay, let's finish this one with a big woo-woo. Woo-woo! Thank you! Fans alike out there just going, oh, you're just sucking up to all the famous people. It's like, I don't care, man. I don't care. It's funny, man. It's funny, eh? I don't care what you think. That's what I mean. Because, like, if I see a funny, then it's a funny, eh? I want to get Dollywood with all the excellent goodies out there. So, you know, golden pearly gates, here I come. One day you will open. Thank you. Hey, I know what's funny about it. Hey, it's going to be one of those funny days. What happened is I just woke up and I only had 3 hours sleep. And yesterday I was up 20 or 21 hours. So because I only had 3 hours sleep, I must still be overtired even though I had the sleep. So everything's still funny because I'm still overtired. Oh, that's funny, hey, funny, yes, that's funny. Oh, I'm still overtired even though I had the sleep. Ah, oh, that's why everything's funny, hey. Oh, God bless the comedians of the world. Thank you. Been accidentally watching the Hamish and Andy you watch a video and then the next one plays and then the next one plays and then the next one plays and stuff like that, and you can't stop watching it because it's just so funny. And I watched like 10 of them or something. Oh man, too funny, eh? But now I have to get over and go, oh, get up to date with my Twitter ethics, eh? Twitter etiquette. And yeah, and then I have to think about how else I can get into Hollywood, eh? Ah, God bless everything. Oh, this is a serious issue for me. Hollywood hits treasure my number 6. Just last night I made up the number 5, the lentil stew Hollywood hits resume, lentil powered stew, you know, you get the picture, thank you, I take my job seriously, that's for sure, thank you. Okay, this is a true story as well from Hollywood hits resume. My cat's on my lap at the moment. I'm actually sitting on the rug on the floor with my computer set up so I don't got to sit on the chair all day, you know. It's like the floor, computer, couple of computer screens on the floor with me. So my cat's on my lap, lapping it up, purring and stuff. And, you know, sometime I pick his fleas and stuff, you know, because he's a good cat and stuff, you know, likes getting pats and scratch on the chin and stuff and purr and listen. You can probably hear him purring, hey, it's true, see, true story, he's sitting on my lap purring. So last joke was so funny, I couldn't wait to say it so quickly, so I could put my voice recorder down and get back to picking fleas, eh? I'm not actually trying to be funny, even though it made me laugh when I realised it too. True story, do you think this will get me into Hollywood? I don't know, put it on your resume, give it a go. God bless everything, eh? Picking fleas for Hollywood, what next, eh? Speaking of this for a good motto, hey, it's the little things in life that are like right in front of your face. But it's just the way you perceive them that whether you see it as funny or not. So it's right in front of your face and you just got to get the God on perspective, hey. There's funnies out there, man. Picking fleas for Hollywood, hey. Oh, what next? God bless everything. Meow, meow, meow. Mouthed up, hey. Mouthed up for funnies. That's how Fairy Skittle says mouth stuff. Mouth, 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 mouth. Mouthed up for funnies. He thinks those flea jokes are funnies, my cats, that's for sure. So yeah, happy mouthed up day, world. Hope this gets me into Hollywood as well, way. The Twitter blues. I've got the Twitter blues. I don't know which one to tweet about. Maybe I should just, like, try and get my own fame without, you know, going, look at me, funny tweeting on the other comedians. But, you know, it's like, shit, you can't look at this, so funny. Oh, whatever. I hope this one gets me into Hollywood Tie. You know, go the tweet. Hyping up the tweets of the other comedians, because God bless comedians, like, comedy's like a gift from God himself, you know. Laugh it off, people, laugh it off. Give yourself a break and feel better about life and just laugh and stuff, you know. God blesses comedians in amazing ways and stuff, and the whole world laughs and laughs and stuff. It's like, it can only be a God blessing, hey. So I hope I've done justice to the word comedian today on my new Hollywood Hits resume. Thank you, and God bless, and thank you, and God bless, thank you.
By far, it's ding, 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 it's Albert Frankenstein. Frankenstein, bing, oh, Frankenstein, bing. Ding, 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 Albert Frankenstein. Oh, ding, oh, ding, oh, ding, 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 bing. Doors, dings, ding, ding, ding. Albert Frankenstein, oh, ding, ding, ding. Ding, 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 ding. Frankenstein, bing, sting, bing, sting, bing. It's Albert Frankenstein, ding, ding, bing.
Jackals, 45, rise up now. Jackals, 45, rise up now. Jackals, rise up now.